Hello friends, welcome to my another video lecture on common source amplifier small signal model analysis. Okay, so this is one of the very important question. Like in my previous video, I have explained you how to analyze any small signal model related question. Like here also the question may come like this, that for the given circuit, calculate the voltage gain using the small signal model of the MOSFET. Okay, so the question is for CS amplifier with enhancement load. Okay, so what is enhancement load? You should understand first. Okay, so this structure you all know, that is, this is for basic CS amplifier. Okay, here we are applying DC plus AC in the gate. DC is used to make this MOSFET, to keep this MOSFET in saturation region, and we are applying small AC signal to amplify it, right? Now we have to replace the resistor by something, enhancement load. What is enhancement load? Enhancement load is nothing but diode connected MOSFET. Okay, see, the another name of MOSFET is, this kind of MOSFET is enhancement MOSFET. Why? Because if you observe the operation, see, if you keep on increasing VG, what will happen? The thickness of the free electron channel will basically increase, and as thickness increases, area will increase. As area increases, the resistance in between source and drain, or the resistance offered by the channel, will decrease. Okay, so the channel thickness is in, you can enhance this using changing VGS or increasing VGS, right? So that it is called enhancement MOSFET also. So if you are asked to analyze CS amplifier with enhancement load, then that is diode connected MOSFET you have to use. Diode connected MOSFET behaves like a resistor, already I explained in my previous video. So this is my original circuit now, which I have to analyze for this particular question. Okay, now for the time, let us first focus on this particular part. Okay, so you know how to replace this MOSFET by its corresponding AC equivalent model, but what about this diode connected MOSFET? Very simple, just take the diode connected MOSFET part, that is this one. Now you know that this is the basic small signal model of the MOSFET, that is, for this M1 MOSFET we can replace the MOSFET by this small signal model. But for this case, see, very simple, just gate and drain are short circuited. So here you just connect this part with one wire and you will get the small signal model corresponding to the diode connected MOSFET. Okay, that is this one. Very simple, right? Now you see, this was our original structure, okay, in the given question, which we have to analyze, which we have to calculate, for which circuit we have to calculate gain or voltage gain. See, now this circuit becomes this one. Why? See, observe carefully, no need to worry about anything, this circuit is very simple. Just I have replaced the diode connected MOSFET by its corresponding AC equivalent model here, okay. You can see that VDD, that is DC voltage, is grounded, because you know in AC analysis DC voltage source is short circuited and AC DC current source is open circuited. So as this VDD is DC voltage, so it is short circuited to the ground. Fine. And see, rest of the whole circuit is same, only this M1 MOSFET is replaced by its corresponding AC equivalent model. And you can see that this is M2 MOSFET, so that all the parameters I have represented with respect to 2, like VGS2, similarly GM2 VGS, here it will be VGS2, okay, then R0.2, the output resistance of the transistors will vary for different transistors. It depends, basically R0 and output resistance, as you know, is equal to 1 by lambda into current, drain current. So it will depend on device. So this is R0.2. No, don't make these two same. Okay. And similarly for this case, this is VGS1, GM1, VGS1 and R0.1. Okay. Now we have to calculate the voltage gain for this MOSFET, right? So that is V output by V input, or we can say with respect to this circuit, V output by VGS1 or V output by V input. Okay, VGS2 is not the input, right? And one more thing, you can make one just recap of your concept, that as you know, this is diode connected MOSFET, so this MOSFET always in which region? Correct, this MOSFET will be always in saturation region because in this case always VDS is greater than VGS minus VT because VDS equal to VGS. So obviously VDS will be greater than VGS minus VT, right? I have already explained in detail about diode connected MOSFET. You can check the link given in the description if you want the detailed explanation, okay? So now our target will be by applying simple concept of fundamentals of electrical circuit, whether that may be nodal analysis or mesh analysis, whatever, we have to calculate V output by VGS1 or V output by V input. See how, what is my approach? See, this is our original circuit, right? In the small signal model representation, very simple. See, VGS2 and VGS1 both are present, but see, you can represent VGS2 with respect to V output. Why is so? If you can observe carefully, VGS2 is nothing but the gate to source potential for the M2 MOSFET, where gate is connected to ground, so that VG is 0 for this upper MOSFET, and VS, see, the source of the M2 MOSFET is connected with the V output. So source voltage for the M2 MOSFET is basically V output. Okay, so basically VGS2 is nothing but VG2 minus VS2, that is ground potential minus of V output, that is minus of V output. So basically for this MOSFET, VGS2 is equal to minus of V output. That's what I have written here. VGS2 equal to VG2 minus VS2, that is nothing but 0 minus V output, that is nothing but minus of V output. Now you replace that V GS2 by minus of V output, and you will get this part, that is minus of GM2 into V output, and here R output 2, that is output resistance of the transistor is there, here R output 1 and GM1 VGS1 V output. See, we have not drawn this part of the circuit because this is not our interest, because this will not affect in analysis of this right hand side of the part, right? Because no current can go through this path because these are open circuit. So we have just removed this part. Make your circuit as simple as you can before applying some nodal or mesh analysis, okay? Now you can apply the concept of nodal or mesh analysis here. Very simple. Just see, the potential of this node is V output. Consider all the currents are outgoing, only minus of GM to V output is entering. So very simple, in total entering current in this node is equal to total outgoing current. What will be that? Minus of GM2 into V output equal to, this is only entering current, equal to GM1 VGS1, that is this entering current, plus current flowing through R02, that is V output, minus of ground potential by R02, okay, that is this factor, plus V output minus ground potential by R01. Okay, see here I have written, very simple, you just simplify that and you will get just what I have done. V output R01, that is we have taken minus of GM2 V output in the right hand side and GM1 VGS1 in the left hand side, you can say, and then interchange, you will get this expression, that is V output by R output 1 plus V output by R output 2 plus GM2 into V output is equal to minus of GM1 into VGS1. Take common V output in the left hand side, you will get V output into 1 by R01 plus 1 by R02 plus GM2 equal to minus of GM1 VGS1. So from here we can get V output by VGS1 or V output by V input for this particular circuit is minus of GM1 by 1 by R01 plus 1 by R02 plus GM2. Okay, so very simple. See what I have done, whether I have used some new concept? No, just I have followed whatever we have studied in our small signal model analysis. Just new concept is, as here in the diode connected MOSFET gate and drain are short circuited, so here also we'll short circuit gate and drain. That's all, okay? Rest you can do by your own, okay? So basically in this way you have to solve this kind of questions in semiconductor device and circuit paper or in analog electronic circuit paper. If certain circuits are given and they ask you to calculate the voltage gain using the small signal model concepts, okay? This is all for this video. These are very, very important concepts with respect to these two subjects. One is semiconductor device and circuit or SDC. Another one is analog electronic circuit or AEC. Practice this one, surely you will get 10 marks question in your assessment or in your final exam. Okay, so practice this well, have a clear idea in this and score it well, understand the concept well. This is all for my this video. Thank you for watching, and if you have any doubt regarding how to analyze this CS amplifier with its corresponding AC equivalent model, please go through the link given in the description. Okay, thank you.